What is up, guys? Today we're going to be covering an awesome Python library that I absolutely love, pyodbc, for connecting Python to Microsoft SQL Server, coming up. All right, I'm really excited about this video because I absolutely love this library. This is not going to be an all-inclusive covering every kind of nuance about this library, but this is going to be a quick start guide, so you're going to be able to get started, you know, start running right away. Here we go. First thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to install the pyodbc library using pip or conda. So I'm going to assume that you have that down, and then you're going to import the library, which we're going to do here. And I'm going to use a Jupyter notebook because it's super easy to run as we go, and you don't want to hear me and watch me typing the whole time. So I'm just going to run these cells as we go, and you'll be able to see the results, and I'll explain what I'm doing. So I'm going to import the library. Next is the connection string. So the connection string is pretty simple, and you actually use it with this connect method with pyodbc. If you're connecting to a Microsoft SQL Server, no matter what connection string you're using, it's pretty much going to look like this. This is if you're connecting to a SQL server with a username and password. So that's the first method. The next is if you have Windows authentication. And in that case, all you're doing is you're changing UID and PWD with trusted connection equals yes. And that's really all there is to it. Now, about the driver. So there you may have several drivers available to you. If you don't know what to put, this is SQL Server. You can actually use pyodbc.drivers. And it will tell you what drivers are available to you. All right, so now I'm going to create my connection string, and I'm going to store it in a variable. So this is what I'm going to connect to. I'm actually using the Microsoft AdventureWorks 2017 database. I'll put the link below in the comments. You can actually download this and restore it from a backup and be able to play in this database yourself. So I'm going to create this. All right, next I'm going to create a variable to store the query that I'm going to use. And I'm going to select the name and credit rating from purchasing.vendor, where credit rating is less than 3. There we go. All right, now let's connect and extract data. And I'm going to show you two methods. This is going to show you each step in the process. So creating the connection, creating the cursor, running the query, etc. And then I'm going to show you how to do this with a with statement that's really, it consolidates the process, makes it a lot quicker. All right, so we're going to create a connection using the connection string and the pyodbc connect method. And what we do is we just use this right here. We pass connection string that we've created up here as an argument. Run that. All right, that's done. Next, we got to create a cursor object because the cursor object is really what lets you manipulate data and maneuver in the database. Created. That's done. All right. Now we're going to run the query using cursor.execute. So I'm going to use the execute method of the cursor object, and I'm going to pass query as an argument. There we go. All right. Now that we've run the query, we need to pull that data out of the cursor, and we're going to store it in a data variable. So we're going to use cursor.fetchall. Boom. We got it. All right. Now let's display the results and check the data. I'm going to show the first 5 records. All right, here we go. Now we're starting to see something. All right, now we want to close the connection using close connection on that const object. There we go. That's basically, you know, a step-by-step approach to connecting, querying data, fetching the results, and then printing what we got. All right, so now let's look at a way that's a little bit more consolidated. And it's basically we're doing all that right here. The reason I'm using with is that what it's going to do, it's going to open a connection and it's going to perform all of these. As soon as it's done with, it's going to close it automatically. A lot of times you'll see people open files that way too, so they don't have to manually close the file. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do pretty much the same thing as I did above. I'm going to create a connection with that connection string. Creating a cursor object. I'm going to use that object to run a query, and then I'm going to fetch the records into the data. All right, so let's run that. Done. All right, now let's see those results. There we go. All right, this is looking good. All right, actually, if I wanted just to show that there is actually other things in here. There we go. We got some more information. All right, now I want to go through a couple other useful methods that I really like. pyodbc lets you access the data as a named tuple. If you don't know what that is, I'm going to put a link in the comments below. Named tuples are really cool. At the end of the day, what it does is it lets me access the columns by their column names. This is a list of tuples with each tuple representing a row. So I have the, what columns are these again? The name and credit rating. Okay, so this is the name, this is the credit rating, and this is the row. All right, so when I'm running this loop, I'm saying for each row in the first five records of the data, I'm going to print row.name and row.creditRating, and I'm just inserting this in an F string, which is a nice way of printing information. So what that looks like is this. All right, so you can see I was able to access this by calling it by its name and credit rating. So very cool. There's a lot of different things you could do with that. I just wanted to show you and let that percolate in your mind. Next, we're going to retrieve column names. There's a lot of different information that you can get about the table and about the database itself. And I'm going to show you too, there's actually a lot more than that, but you can see that in the documentation, which I would encourage you to read. All right, so we're gonna retrieve the column names for a table, and I'm gonna store it in a list called columns. I'm going to use actually a list comprehension. And if you don't know what that is, I'll put a link below that you can read in the Python documentation. Essentially, to oversimplify it, it's a really, really cool way of creating a list. All right, so basically what it means is for each row in cursor.columns, give me the column name from that row. And I'm specifying the table as vendor. And then I'm also asking it to print those columns. There we go. Those are the columns in the vendor table. Next, I'm going to retrieve a list of tables in the database, and there's a lot of them, so I'm only going to return the first five tables in the database. Again, I'm going to use a list comprehension, and this is cursor.tables, all right? And I'm going to get the row.table name for each row in the cursor.tables. I'm going to print the first five records, all right? So there, it's giving me a list of these tables. All right, select queries with parameters. All right, so here we're going to create a query and we're gonna pass an argument into the query. We're gonna use a filter. And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna query the national ID number and the job title from the human resources table where the gender equals question mark. The question mark is a placeholder. It stands for a parameter or an argument that can pass to it. So here's my regular SQL query. And if I was writing SQL, instead of gender equals question mark, I would have actually put F for female. But instead, I'm going to indicate that I want this parameter to be inserted or replaced for that. You're gonna see why that's cool in just a second. All right, so let's run that. And then let's look at what we got by printing those records. Okay, so I've got these first five records that met this criteria, all right? Now I'm going to do multiple parameters, all right? And this is still stuff that you'll be familiar with. Now I'm going to look for the same table from the same columns where gender equals question and vacation hours is less than question, okay? And I'm going to substitute for those question marks this tuple of parameters male and 40. The thing about this is it's gotta be an iterable item. So it can be a tuple, it can be a list, it can be other things that are iterable, but it's gotta be iterable and it's got to match the same number of parameters that are in the query. So I have two parameters here. I have two items here that I'm passing into that. That has to match, otherwise it's gonna error out. Now let's run that. Boom, there we go. All right. Well, let's talk about insert queries. And here we're gonna create a variable that contains a connection string. And the reason we're going to do this is because I want to insert something into a different database than I'm pulling information out of. All right, so let's go ahead and create that connection string. And this is just a local server that I have on my computer. All right, let's insert a single record. You're familiar with this already. I'm creating a connection, I'm creating a cursor. The cursor is going to allow me to execute a query. And the query is an insert query, but I can run it here like I would any other query. And when I run that, it's going to insert those values, which I'm going to validate here. And that was definitely not what, shoot. My apologies, guys. I had forgotten to delete everything from that table. So when I ran the select statement, it showed stuff already. And I was like, what the heck? All right, so once again, let's insert this record into that table. All right, there we go. Now, what I'm gonna do is select everything from that table, select all from vacation exceptions, and there we go, that's what I was expecting. All right, now we're gonna insert multiple records from values. All right, so this is where this parameter thing is gonna be cool. All right, so I've created a list of tuples, and each tuple represents a row of data. We've got the ID number, the job title, and the vacation hours. ID number, job title, vacation hours, okay? So now with that, I'm going to create a connection, I'm gonna create a cursor, and then I'm going to execute mini, all right? And what that means is, basically, I'm going to execute this query every time for each of the items in this list of exceptions. So I'm gonna run it here, and then I'm gonna run it here. And I'm gonna do it for these three parameters. So in this list right here, it's going to find three parameters every time it runs, and then it's going to insert it into the table. So let's go ahead and run that. There we go. All right, now if we did that right, I'm going to just connect to the database, select all from vacation exceptions, and then I'm gonna print every row for that's in the data right there. All right, there we go. That makes sense. I put this in there and then I put these two, so there should be three. Finally, this one is cool. We previously created a data variable that included all males with vacation hours less than 40. We're gonna take that data and load it into this table. Just like we created an iterable list here, that list that we stored, where is it? Here we go. This list that we stored, this is the same format. It's a list of tuples. So we can take that and we can insert it into this database just like we did the other things. Now I'm going to query that same table and I'm gonna pull the first 10 records just to see if it worked. There we go. If you like this video, make sure you smash that like button and hit subscribe for future updates. Talk to you later.